mean to until. Okay, so I'm gonna do one more quick review, guys. This is June. This is for our basically show the 1.0 and talk about the differences of the 2.0 and the 3.0, and then a few other housekeeping notes. We're gonna make this video so I can post it on YouTube. So I'm gonna go ahead and do this share screen. And this is just for anybody who hasn't heard about it. Okay. I hate this damn thing. And for some reason, I didn't get in there quite right. There you go. Cool. All right. For anybody who's heard about the 1.0, let's see if it shows up. Can you guys? Okay, cool. All right. So this is the 1.0 lender and investor database. I've done a few videos on it. I've introduced everybody to it. So this has been out for a little while. We are releasing. I just got confirmation yesterday from our VA who's building the 2.0. So I'm going to go real quick, just one little final review for people to know what's going on. So these have the lenders on three different databases. When the 2.0 comes out, this lenderless one that I have here right now will actually have 850 lenders just on this one lender list. And so everybody can say, like, here on it, you got like Berkshire Capital Financial here. There in New York, you got the address. They do all kinds of lending. They do mezzanine, they do bridge. They're providing value-added financing solutions for commercial real estate transactions, including interim mezzanine construction and permanent financing. You got like a couple other ones. I mean, these 850 of them will come back total. There's also another 200 and something on this on lender list two, and there's about the lender list three is pretty, not too many, about 30. There's actually about 32. So, and then one of them will be taken out. There's like two still that I got to remove. So guys, for those of you what's going to happen on the new one, on the 2.0, is we're going to be adding seven more lists. So like this is lender list one, two, and three. We're going to be adding single family offices, multifamily offices, hedge fund, fund of funds, investment consultants, institutional investment consultants, pension funds, and endowment funds. And it's going to have all these funds. It's going to have 10 databases. And you're going to be able to, really quick open these up. You'll be able to come over here to the pivot table fields. You can click on the lender. As you can start opening these up, you can click on your lenders and you can start, clicking on contact details and funding types. It's going to open it up. It's really going to open it up wide. So when you get over here and you get into like lenders one, you can open up, here's your contact details, a little more, a little bit more room. Yeah. And then you can also, the one thing that we're going to fix for the 3.0 won't be able to fix for the 2.0 is we'll create the separation where the websites are. So we do have websites and emails. This is just how it ended up getting put in there. But we've done like 95% of the work. So I know it's a little pain in the ass to have to go in there and get the email address and the website and all that stuff. We also got preferred lending type. Just will say, hey, you got hard money here. You got hard money. You got factoring. They'll do factoring. So here's one that says church. That's a really unique field. I don't think anybody in our group needs church, but if you guys are ever brokering a deal or working on a deal for a church, we do have a handful of church and farm invest. And here's a medical. They'll actually do kind of factoring and kind of merchant cash advance for doctors and dentists, working capital. So there's a whole, loss. Most of it's bridge, hard money. Here's some rehab. This is a rehab. Pretty much it's a great company to do rehab financing for. And you can keep breaking it down even more. You can go secondary, other funding types. So might do farm, residential, land. You got working capital. You got hard money, bridge, land. Here you got, you got construction. Here's equity. You got joint ventures. I'll do joint ventures with you, mezzanine. There's a whole bunch of different types of lending and stuff in there. So like I said, what's going to happen is that seven more databases will be added. The 3.0 is going to come back and it's going to add seven, actually it's going to add seven plus three additional ones for private equity, for real estate, and REIT. There'll be 10 more databases added to these lender lists. So they will not, on that one, we will actually take out the family offices and we'll take out the endowment funds. We will put those back in to whatever we're going to call after the 3.0, because I'm not going to get like stupid and go 405060. We're going to basically then have one that's going to be all like hedge funds, single family offices, multifamily offices, venture capitalists, tech investors. There's also hospitality. Yeah. So we'll have that available. And that will be pretty much anybody really outside of real estate. We'll actually probably put that one on the market because it'll have probably 10,000. The 3.0 will have 10,000. So will the 2.0. Then the one that's going to have all the venture capitals will have another 10,000 of just, and it won't have any of the real estate ones. So the 3.0 will be all real estate, 100% real estate. There won't be any family offices or multifamily offices or anything like that. That's kind of guy showing it has just one more time on the 1.0. Like I said, I'm expecting associates will receive it by the June 19th. They'll receive it, which is, they'll receive it next week. They'll receive the 2.0. And then we will on the class on the 21st, we will actually review it in detail. And it'll be the 2.0. The 3.0 will come out sometime mid-July. It needs about a month to get it done. And I'm having another VA actually go through and try to contact a lot of these, most of these, at least these lenders. So they're trying to contact all the lenders. They won't be able to do as many of the family offices because there's like just too many of them, with 8,000 of them. But this will all be available to everybody by the 21st. And then we'll actually, the associates will receive it. And then the public and other people who would like it can actually purchase it at that time. We'll have the pricing for it. So anybody who's watching that, you know, you guys are struggling to find an investor or a lender for your real estate transaction, hit up any one of my associates and then hit me up and we can help you get access to them. So this is the 1.0 database, guys. And what we're also talking about is a situation where we're going to be July 1st, we're going to be raising the price of the associate program to $3,500. And I'm working on a deal right now to get everybody access to two separate third party. You've heard me talk about, I'm not going to mention them today, but you'll get, if I can work out everything in time, we'll actually be able to give you 1 year memberships to two of our friends' platforms. And then coming to the end of the year, we'll have access to the virtual program, which will be a virtual training program. So imagine then being able to access a whole litany of
everything under the sun that we've been talking about during.
Yep. All pre-recorded, professionally produced, everything. It's going to be on the Lightspeed VT, like Vermont, Texas. .com platform. You guys can go to their website. You can see what we're doing. And if you go to stormventuresgroup.com, completely different industry, but go to their contractor store and you'll see their store. You'll be able to actually get packages of all the contract packs at that point, just like they do for their industry. They're in the storm business. So they have a production manager pack. They have a sales manager pack. They have all the different packets. You'll be able to order that same kind of stuff through us and get all your packets, all your contracts, all your wholesale agreements, all your addendums, your scope of work, everything in those packets. And then you'll also be able to access a virtual platform. There'll be some live events. We'll probably have a weekly thing. And I'm looking at some point of being able to do like a news kind of thing. Every day we'll kind of update people on what's going on. What's the latest in the private money industry? How's real estate going? Yep.
It's about a month to put all this together to have that set up where we can update that and keep it up to date. I've got a whole bunch of stuff that I ran into today that kind of backs up everything that I've been looking at for the last two or three years. And once we can put it in a form that people can digest, we are going to be able to break it down into segments as far as what industries are affected by the different things that are going on and where we think things are going. Just a little bit of a heads up now. We have $1.5 trillion worth of commercial loans that are looking to go bad between now and the next 6 months. They're not thinking the banks are going to be able to cover it. There's another $1 billion to $1.5 billion worth of short-term bonds that the Treasury Secretary Yellen is putting on the market now as we speak. It's going to put more stress on those banks. So we're going to find an awful lot of stuff that's going to come up cheap that they're going to try to get rid of that's not going to be covered by any of the usual alphabet soup people. And that's going to be an opportunity that we need to be in a position to come in here and grab those. The same thing is going to happen with residential real estate, but it's going to come in chunks. And it's going to be a lot longer because of all the different things that are going on with that market. The new housing starts are still kind of high right now. So it's going to be difficult to be able to gauge what the kind of situation is going to be. But there won't be a whole lot of people writing loans unless they're private loans, which again drops everything into our lap virtually because we know where this money is located. We know how to make it work. We know how to get everything that everybody needs to be able to get these deals done in a timely fashion. And that's what this whole thing has been about since the get-go. So everybody that's in this program needs to really get ready. And as soon as we get this intelligence thing set up, it's hopefully be in the next 30 days. That's about the last tool in the toolbox that we need to put in here. So Nate's going to keep everybody abreast of that. And then I'll be coming in with Nate and doing these updates on the side, whether we do this in a phone call or if we do it on a YouTube, we're not sure yet, but we'll know more about it probably in the next 2 weeks.
Yeah, guys, a lot of stuff's going on out there. We're going to keep you up abreast of it. I'm getting some good, you know, and Kevin's looking at like Jim Rickards and his contacts. I'm actually looking at a lot of information coming out of Rock, you guys, ROC, which is one of the companies that's participating in the correspondent lending program. So Rock Financial, Rock Capital, Rock, you know, they've got all their different entities. They put out a lot of good information on their website. It's actually, you guys can update, you can access it yourself. But I'm going to be consolidating the information from about 20 different blogs. I've got a couple of the securities attorneys. I get information from them. So I'm going to be putting together a lot of stuff now for the Monday night sessions. It's not going to be for the Wednesday. Keep in mind, Wednesday is going to be guys like going back to school. It's going to be very detailed starting this week. We did a little bit last week, 0 week, because I've got a lot of stuff to cover in Fast Track. Once Fast Track is done at the end of June, when we come back on the, it'll be actually the second week of July on the Wednesday, guys, part one's going to start. It's going to be very intense. A lot of sessions. I've got 4,000 pages of material I'm going through right now to give you guys actually curriculum and case studies. These are things that I have not put out there to the public yet. I have not even given them to you guys, the associates. So I'm spending a lot of my time during the day, guys, getting a lot of stuff together, curriculum that'll follow the map of the part one and the part two. We'll do analyzers for a couple of weeks. We're going to end on November 16th. If we have to fill in and do extra sessions, we'll adapt to the Monday sessions until the point where we start having lenders and investors. After, you know, I get the 2.0 out to you guys next week, I'm going to be able to start also spending a lot of time trying to invite the lenders and investors to come to the group. I'm also going to be doing an exercise with John Husband, who's one of our new associates from last week. John and I are going to be doing something in a couple of weeks. I'm actually going to be starting a brand new, fresh LinkedIn. I canceled my LinkedIn last year because you need about a year to let it, you know, evaporate. I'm building an all new LinkedIn from scratch. I'm going to be importing all of the CSV files from our family offices. We don't have them for the lenders, but I have almost 20,000 contacts will be imported into that LinkedIn. I'm going to show you guys how to use the CSV files. So I'm hesitating to upload them into the download, so you can download them in files, because some people, you got to know what the CSV files, when you open them, when you download them, don't open them because they look like code. I've gotten to people before and they get upset. Hey, where'd you send it? It's still corrupted. It's supposed to be that way. It's in code. It's not like Excel's. You can get the Excel files. We have the matching CSV files. So when we put the CSVs in a LinkedIn, guys, I'm going to have probably out of 20,000 contacts, I'm probably going to have 5,000 to 8,000 friends right away within 30 days on LinkedIn. They're all hedge funds, family offices, endowment fund people. When we were doing this before, Kevin and Jesse and I were talking to people on LinkedIn. We actually had like the pension fund manager for the Los Angeles Fire Department. You know, they're obviously not going to do real estate. You got it. For them to give you money, you got to have, you know, a serious like 10-year track record, because they're putting firefighters' retirements at stake by investing them. But it kind of shows you the level of contacts. I mean, it doesn't hurt to have them as a friend, because if you're going out there to raise money or talk to people, it just kind of gives them credibility. Hey, this guy, this person knows these billion-dollar multi, you know, because how many billions of dollars do you think is in the Los Angeles Firefighters Pension Fund? I mean, a couple, there's some serious billions in that fund. So we're going to be putting that together to show you guys how to do it yourself. So that way you can do it. This is about maximizing your guys' effort. When we come back, we got the virtual platform. We're going to be doing a lot of stuff with that. I'm reaching out to Chris Galicki so we can go through the numbers from 2019. They were solid. Nothing is really going to be affected. Actually, I think we're going to be a lot better off because of COVID, because people are gravitating towards wanting to do more virtual. You know, it's great. I want to go to the MPLA conference, used to be the football conference. I want to go to a few other conferences live. I want to have our own, but I think it's a lot more cost effective. You know, you can actually go to multiple, and you know, you can do Rod Cleef's next boot camp for $97 for 3 days. It's 3 days on. You can't beat that deal. Rod Cleef is the true master of multifamily. If you take, you know, I'd much rather, because Rod's one of my friends. I've actually gone to a couple of his events live before COVID. He's the true genius. The guy is incredible. So if you ever have a chance to go to Rod Cleef's multifamily event, you will learn a lot. He gives you a lot of material to take with you. It's like stuff you cannot get anywhere else. So I still have all of his stuff. I mean, it's like, I got like his stuff is like the Bible of multifamily. So like you guys, so you're going to see me do a deep dive in about about 4,000 pages of instruction and case studies are going to be in this part one and this part two. We're going to be giving you guys like almost like school assignments. You know, you guys can study them and you guys can, we're going to pick properties apart. We're going to do a lot of stuff and we'll do some physical assets towards the end in part two. You're going to learn how to underwrite. You're going to learn how to transaction coordinate. So you're going to be learning these positions in the part two segment of what, if you worked for like Rock or Togo as an underwriter, if you were one of their employees, part one's about you guys brokering, lending and borrowing. Part two is going to be really doing a deep dive. We're going to throw in some raising capital. Securities attorneys have been invited. I'm going to try to bring them in for part two so we can cover SEC, Regulation D. A lot of the Regulation D stuff has passed now. It's all part of law. It has been being updated the last couple of years of what you can do and also raising money. So that's all going to be part two. Part one and after Fast Track is going to be just 2 months of solid. And we might use, like I said, we may use half of the Mondays just to cover that much material. There's going to be a lot of stuff I'm going to be posting, making videos for you guys just to watch on the side because there's just too much stuff to do. And Fast Track right now, we're finishing that up by the 28th. That's designed for you guys to get brokering. If you can lend money, we've got several people. John Husband's a lender too. He's got money. We know we got a few other guys in the group. We want to get you guys lending. We want to get you guys brokering. And we want to get you guys start getting your properties done. If you haven't had a conversation with Cameron yet, I encourage you guys to try to get on his list and also talk to, you know, if you've got a project, guys, there's some of you have projects. I know Bill and Willie are on. I know you guys definitely need to talk to Jesse if you guys got projects. I know Bill, you got that stuff going with Dan, but Dan's probably got the most capacity to do some very large deals right now. And we're going to try to introduce you to some other people that can do those kind of deals as well. But like I said, a lot of stuff's going on right now, and like I said,
Kevin, we're going to do that here in house, just not ship things completely out to lunch, but that day is very soon to be here. So
yeah, there's a lot of stuff, guys, going on. I mean, it's like it's just like I'm really excited. It's just I want to I'm just saying we're going to go until November 16th, and who knows, we may actually even have to go a couple weeks into December before Christmas. I didn't want to. I wanted to give it a break, but just too much stuff to give you guys. I want you guys to have every tool you have, every tool you can, every lender you can, every possible investor, and every resource you have. And then we get this virtual platform going, and we get this system that I'm working on right now between Scope and I've reached out to Benson at Privy. If I can get them on board, where I basically, you know, we're going to be able to get everybody just, you know, our group's going to basically, we're going to be the group everybody else wants to join because it's like, you know, and you guys have heard about the other, you know, you guys know the other group that's kind of related to reptile for loans. We're going to basically, I think we're going to be able to provide a lot of stuff that they don't, you know, right away. And I'm pretty excited about this. So we're going to be really focusing on the Wednesday nights. Like I said, guys, it's going to be very academic. you know, and I'm actually using ChatGPT to help me generate some of the materials that I'm putting together. There's a lot of stuff that I can I'm able to access like 1,000 times more information than I've ever had before.
Well, that might work better than you trying to get in here and get your files off of that thing and up.
Yeah. Well, no, I mean, I'm able to actually go in and take that week's subject, and I'll actually be able to make a, you know, kind of, and then I can go get that information that it tells me. And I've got the information already, 4,000 pages that I have to go through. I mean, stuff I've never actually presented, because people got to be prepared. I mean, you know, we're going to tell you guys it's going to be this much material, and it's going to be like 2 hours at night, but you're probably going to have to look at some of it on your own time. It's I want to make sure, like I said, you guys have every tool in your and available to you. So anyway, I know Doris is on, and Bill and Willie. So let me see if you guys got anything. Doris, you got anything new? I know we were working on trying to find you a domain and all that stuff over the weekend. So on the brokering side, and then Bill and Willie. Bill, what's going on? How are you? I know we had our conversation a couple of days ago.
Yeah, doing okay.
Cool.
I don't know, everything's been a little bit rocked up right now, so got to smooth out some bumps in the road here.
Yeah, they happen all the time. Yeah.
Yeah, and that's basically with an individual that I brought onto my team with me, and they're starting to show some true colors that aren't that great. So,
yeah, dude, I bet we've been there, done that.
Oh yeah,
2019, 2020. I've been there, done that with people that. So
yeah,
you'll get through it. I mean, we did, and I mean, it's just gotta. I think we gotta. And we got 60 people in the group now, guys, around 60 people. So I think I'm trying to tap into the resources and make sure we get people here now, you know, but we've got a lot of people going on, but whatever you guys need, just reach out to me. I'm a lot more, I'll be free tomorrow afternoon and Thursday, and then Wednesday. I'll play it by ear, because if we win the NBA championship this week, I might end up going down to the parade. I'm not really a basketball guy, but you know, I got to support the home team. I actually haven't been to a Nuggets game in 20 something years. It's not like Broncos, and I hear my Broncos Super Bowl hat. I'm kind of supporting the Nuggets by wearing this, because I'm like, hey, I'm not going to buy a NBA Nuggets hat until they win the championship, but I might buy one just to support the home team or whatever. Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday, I'll have a lot of availability if anybody wants to do one-on-one calls. And then Willie, what's going on? How are you? Are you, how's Mr. Furley tonight? We're not going to get
you. Good, man. Not doing too much. I got maybe a 200K loan I'm looking for a guy who wants to buy a 6-plot RV park. So we're trying to get, you know, how they say we can fund it in 48 hours, but not until we get all the necessary information. So I'm just really waiting on him to stop kicking rocks and send me what he needs. He seems to be okay. He's got 720 credit score, money to put down. So, you know, we're just waiting to see, get his information and see the best terms we can get him for what he's trying to do.
And then Janelle Compton is one of our new members, associates. She's looking at an RV park. I think she posted that in the group last week. So if you check out, if you find an RV lender, that would work too. And then we can also... Hey, Kevin, is Neil still looking at RV parks, or is he looking at...
Well, he's got a deal going up in up towards Steamboat, dealing with a laundromat and some of that. But yeah, he can get back in. That's in his trouble, because he's still got his pulse and all that.
Yeah.
So I'm going to see about checking in and find out where he's at this week, and see what he's come up with, and then probably kicking into somebody to start getting things done.
Yeah, and I talked to Spencer this weekend too, and Spencer thinks that his deal might finally go through. So he's back, and he's doing his he's doing payments on what he owed, so I kind of worked it out with payment plan with him just because it was.
I tried to get him, you know, to the point where he can at least get, you know, the good parts done. Drag the rest out, he's good to go. I mean,
so we're gonna. I mean, I'm excited about the 2.0 because I've been working on it. I talked to his name. I can't believe it. It's hard. He's like Zishan, and I got this guy's Kaleem. So I talked to Kaleem again. So we're going to have the 2.0 officially by next week. And then he's going to start in the 3.0, which is going to be awesome. So we get the 3.0 and everybody's got an 10,000 just real estate, all real estate. So they can just plug that in and, you know.
If we can get that all dialed in at that time, then hopefully they can get the intelligence keys in this thing set up before we get into 3.0. It'll start making a lot more sense because there's going to be stuff that you're going to see when you're interacting with some of these lenders because of the intelligence that you're getting regarding what's going on money-wise out here is going to put you far ahead of everybody else because you're going to understand. And this gets back to what he was trying to tell you a little bit ago about not just knowing what's going on, but understand what the underwriters are doing. Well, if you understand what the money source is and how that's working, and the different economic stresses that are being put into place, in other words, the risk floats, then you can avoid a lot of that, be able to go right to the source and just tell them, hey, look, I've got intelligence that's telling you this is coming up, and with that being the situation, would you be interested in this kind of a deal? Because this is what this deal looks like. Going into the commercial real estate space, if you're picking up something for 10 cents on the dollar, which there will be some of that out there, you know, and you've got a good plan for handling it, then obviously they'll come knocking on your door. Hey, listen, I got stuff in that like that in my portfolio. Can you restructure it? Can you do, I mean, what do you know? And these are the kind of conversations that get you in a spot that nobody else can get into. Period, you know, and you become a specialist in what you're doing. And that's the whole reason for getting this done is being able to put people, pull it out of where you were and put you in a place that's a lot more productive, a lot more meaningful, and a lot more in demand, even before people know that there's a demand for it, then you become the expert. You know, it all comes into that play, into that market. So with all these different tools and then having the intelligence information to go along with it, being able to know where to get more intelligence information and how to look for it, and then you pair it up with these lists. Okay, how are you going to go wrong? How's this going to mess up? I can't see it.
Yeah.
Nobody else is doing this anywhere else. You know,
if you plug in the two components that I've been talking about, and with what we got with our systems, we AI it, we automate it. It's going to be A to Z, guys. You know, Willie, Bill, Doris, you guys AI. are going to have a tool A to Z, does all your fun. You know, literally, I want to try to make it as turnkey as possible.
And then you might be able to take the AI and be able to say where it can go out and find more intelligence information for you as well. So this is one spot, one section at a time. But when it's all finished within the next couple of months, it's going to be unbeatable, period.
Yeah, and I want to, you know, once we have the virtual system, people can log in. You can log in at 2 o'clock in the morning and take like 5-minute modules and do that whole section on like, I want to rehab a Class C property and turn it into Class B. You know, you get 10 modules, and then you basically watch them in 5 to 7 minute modules, and you see somebody who's an expert in it. So we find we have the best person in the multifamily that we have in our group who can actually do the videos. There's going to be 3 levels, obviously, of revenue payout. We're actually going to pay. I'll pay people who participate as instructors and facilitators, and then people who actually do specific. You know, everybody who participates will get a little bit of something too. I think we're going to be able to. Looking at Chris's numbers, I think we're looking at something like $8 to $9 million in revenue by year 3. And I think we can, that was looking at 2019, and people are hungry for this now. And I think you couple that in with the lenders and investors, which were never factored into that whole process that Chris put together. Or and then we look at the AI, we look at all the stuff we have now, the resource library. I honestly think we can double that and we can accelerate it. And all you guys that are associates now could actually tap into the, you know, if we get the revenue streams. And then it'll make us a lot more valuable because people will want to join this when they can come in. They get the virtual system. You get, you know, hell, you could have a securities attorney do a 30 35 to 7 minute videos on regulation D and how to do your, you know, how to do everything you're offering other than what they have to do as an attorney. You could have a whole section for people on LLCs and trusts and all that stuff. Things we talked about this weekend, Doris, we talked about on Friday, you know, how to get your LLCs, how to get your domains and all that stuff. And using, you know, obviously you got Namecheap, GoDaddy, Network Solutions, how to get your, you know, what you need to do for LLCs, why those five states are the best. You know, you've got Wyoming, South Dakota, Alaska, Nevada, Delaware. Those are the five states. And how, what happens if you are in Ohio and you still need to have a foreign entity certificate in your state? But, you know, if you go to Wyoming, both companies in Wyoming, actually, I think there's like four, but the two that I primarily use, I think one of our associates used the other one called Prime Corporate Services or something. I haven't done much research on them. There's a lot of people are mentioning Prime right now. So if you use those guys, you can actually, they can help you get your EIN, but they can also help you get a bank in Wyoming that actually, literally, then you don't have to, you don't have corporate income tax, state income taxes, and you're anonymous. If you guys look at that form I got, you know, private money holdings, there's nothing, we're not on any of the documents that are filed with the state. We have a second part that basically has, you know, that's basically got the partners in it, in the LLC, the members. So with the state of Wyoming, you don't have to worry about ever showing up on the paperwork in the state. Literally, you're anonymous. And that's great for, that's great for COPE, which is charging order protection entity. So a charging order is when you get sued as a business and the judge writes an order, is called a charging order. And that's when they write the writ that, you know, whoever wins a lawsuit can go collect from you. Theoretically, they could actually go right to your bank account with the sheriff with a warrant. And how do I know that? Because my friend Don, who's, who Kevin knows, Don did that once with a guy who owed him a commission for a roof, you know, for a roof, couple roofs he sold. And Don went and sued him, and Don was able to go with the sheriff to the guy's bank and withdraw the money. You know, the sheriff actually took the warrant in. So you, in Wyoming, you are, it's the best state for COPE by far. And South Dakota, there's more like foreign countries outside of Dubai and a few other places. South Dakota has more foreign companies from outside of the United States that have registered there. All this, a lot of trusts are there. Madison Trust is there. A lot of trusts are there because they have the best trust laws, them in Wyoming. Alaska too, but Alaska, you know, I can drive to Cheyenne in less than 2 hours. You can't drive to Alaska, really. I mean, you can, but that's a pain in the ass, supposedly. I had a friend in the Army did it. Yeah.
Prime Corporate Services are ridiculous on their pricing.
Yeah, I've heard that, Bill. So I just had somebody else in the group, another associate, was using them. And I was like trying to get her to go over to the other two.
Yeah, you can do all of this stuff through Wyoming. I looked into Prime Corporate and they wanted to charge $4,900 and something dollars. And then there's a monthly thing. I'm like, what the hell?
Well, you can, for the same money, for the same money, you can go to Wyoming Company and you can get their trust package that has the lawyers on it and has a legal hour. You don't even need to go that far. You know, you can go in and get the LLC package for $400 or whatever, and you're all good. You got the virtual office and the address and the phone and the voicemail and answering and all that. No, Prime. I just mentioned it because some other people were mentioning Prime, and I just looked. I've never heard of them. I know there's a couple other lawyers and stuff up there that do it. You know, and then, so I would use WyomingRegisteredAgent.net and, you know, WYRegisteredAgent.net and then Wyoming Company, which is cool because if you go to Wyoming Company, they got the Age Shelf Corporations. And you can go in there. They got some cool names on there. And obviously someone's a Star Trek fan because they had like Final Frontier, this. And I'm surprised they don't have like the Neutral Zone Consulting. Or, you know, I'm not a Trekkie, but I like the movies better than I do the TV shows. No, it's ridiculous what is all. So there you can get a lot of stuff. They even are getting into some of the decentralized stuff like DAO, which is like covers you if you have like 1,000 people. And they all have voting rights. So let's say a crypto or something, but don't get into crypto right now because the SEC just basically filed civil cases against Coinbase and Binance. And I believe they're going after, I forget which other one, there's another one that's going down, you know, this week. And they're not quite at the point where they're doing,
They're not going to get any traction on that because they don't have any laws that say that you can do that. So it's going to end up, it's basically a shot across the bow, but it's not going to go anywhere. Congress is getting to the point where they're getting fed up with all this nonsense too, and they're about ready to barbecue the chairman there. And I've been seeing that on my intelligence feed too. So I don't think that's going to hold up much longer anyway.
I don't know, I just really want to stay away from crypto though right now. Even
the digital dollar is also at risk right now because they don't want half the stuff that they talk about doing with it to happen. So this is one of those, if you bought a ticket, you paid too much because this is all free, but it's really good entertainment. It's basically what it gets down to. So I'm not all that concerned about crypto at this point. And you can invest in crypto outside the United States. You don't have to be able to do it here. That's the other thing. They can't stop you from doing that either. So it really doesn't make a whole lot of sense to be doing that.
Yeah, I'm kind of like still kind of avoiding crypto. Like we've talked about in the past. But I'm just saying right now, I think obviously hard assets are going to still be the best thing to do. But a lot of the stuff is going down. Like you're saying, $1.5 trillion in commercial real estate. Just looking, just in my walk downtown Denver last week, there was a lot. Holy crap! It's like there's some good deals on renting real estate right now down there. You know, I don't know what I would hate to see what Jared's paying for the 50th floor at Republic Plaza, but I'm sure his rent's probably $25,000 or $30,000 a month for his offices. But there's a lot of opportunity out there in commercial. And I mean, there's still a couple other places in Evergreen opened up for lease and for sale. You know, you can actually buy the building Taco Bell's in, which is it's amazing. So, and where the old McDonald's used to be. And then, of course, so Jack Buchanan's going to turn his paperwork in a couple weeks to build that complex around across from El Rancho. So it'll be good. Oh, by the way, just threw off the subject to all you guys. Sorry, I just told Kevin while he's on. So I got the call from, I got Jack Buchanan's getting me in with the chef at El Rancho, and he talked to the CFO of their company. They have 15 restaurants for the hot sauce.
Everything specifies.
15 restaurants for hot sauce and Bloody Mary mixes. Yep. So, guys, like I said, that's going to be pretty much the schedule. We are going to be very intense and in depth. We're going to finish fast track, so it's still going to be kind of, the style that you guys know for at least the next 3 weeks. And then when we come back in July, man, guys prepared to work. It's 16 weeks of, if you miss a Wednesday night, obviously the video will be available the next day, but guys, I'm going to be sending a lot of stuff to you guys. I'm going to be uploading, and I used to email it. We have way too many people for me to email and message. So I'm trying to make sure people know, hey, you got to get the links in the group and you got to get the downloads in the group because I can't. We just have so much stuff. I'm not going to have a lot of time to be emailing everybody, or messaging links and stuff. So keep in mind that the links for Monday and the links for Wednesday are both pinned in the group, so you'll find them. And I did put Mondays and Wednesdays.
And we're going to end up having the same situation with the intelligence. It's going to end up being a separate system, but it's going to be tied in the group, and there's going to be videos and YouTube stuff available for that as well. So
eventually, by the end of the year,
as we get this done, we may end up having conversations, on a Zoom format for YouTube regarding intelligence and how to utilize it and the different things that people are coming up with the scene. But we just have to, again, with everything he's got and this, it's going to be all modularized and it's going to be in the group.
And we want the associates, we want everybody, all of you guys, everybody's on right now and everybody's listening or will listen tomorrow on the video. You guys contribute to the group with information you got. We'll consolidate it. We don't want to just put it out there. We want to verify it, trust and verify. Let's try to get us out there. We're going to be doing a lot of stuff on the YouTube for the public, like maybe 5 minutes. If we spend 5 minutes on a subject, we're going to spend like an hour talking to you guys, the associates, because that's what you guys are in it for. But we're going to be doing a whole lot of stuff. And by the time we get to the end of the year and we're in the virtual platform and we got the AI and the automation and everything, guys, it's going to be almost, it may just be a login system at that point where you have to log in and you get all the information. And then we'll have some live sessions, obviously, like we're doing now, but everything's going to be, the whole group is, it's going to be pre-recorded. I mean, we're going to be doing a lot of stuff, and I'm going to be trying to get a lot of information. You know, I've got a whole list right now of things to do to set up a studio office, and I've got the location already. It's going to be available in a couple months. I've got all the equipment was for the 8K camera. You know, it's going to be all professional. So we can make all the videos, and we can put all the content out there and all the education materials, and, you know, it's going to be really slick. So I think I joked about that console I posted last week, guys. It has like it looks like a hedge fund. It's not going to be quite like that, but yeah, it's going to be really good. It's going to be a commercial space, and I'm going to be working from. So that'll probably happen sometime fourth quarter into 2024. That's the plan, though. So, and I'm, you know, I've got the list, and I've got everything, getting all the stuff together for it. It's been great, but it's like I need to definitely upgrade. I actually give myself like, everybody says I do better than I think. I really want to. This has to be, you know, I want to be able to do so much for you guys that it's like, I mean, it actually get to the point where I'm satisfied, and I think that's good. I think you never want to be satisfied. That you want to always look to improve and put more quality out there. So I don't have a whole lot more, guys, on Monday night. Like I said, I want you guys just to prepare that Wednesday night's going to be a work night. It's going to be like, you know, we're going to do deep dive. Like I said, all this year, November 16th, Monday night, we'll still be playing by ear like tonight, kind of. And if you guys have deals, obviously hit me up, then we'll take the recordings off and then we'll talk deals. So, matter of fact, I'll probably do that right now. I'll take the recording off, guys. So this ends the recording. So